Hi, hello, namaste. I am your Shankar Hegde. Recently, I have started my astrological classes. I have created a Facebook group and I am charging 1000 rupees for joining the group, and per month charges minimum 500 rupees, and the people who can afford more can give more money as donation. To begin with, I have taken a challenging topic, which is handling Mandi in a challenging way. I consider Mandi and Gulik as the same. Lot of classics and scholars give different methods to predict about Mandi. Some scholars say Mandi is good in 3, 6, 11. Some classics say Mandi is bad in all houses. But what is the fact? In a challenging way, I am going to handle it. Mandi in first house. To begin with, I am taking Mandi in first house. For that, I am giving 25 examples, not one or two. Just by giving one or two or three examples and saying that as a great rule, one cannot become a great researcher or a good astrologer. To begin with, I am giving 25 examples. Later on, I will give more also. What I do, whenever some idea comes into my mind, straight away I open my Parashara Light software, where I have saved thousands of horoscopes. Then I randomly open the charts and check for the required combination. After observing around 50, 60 or 70, some ideas will come into my mind. Then I check the pros and cons of such combinations. In this method, what I have seen are really amazing. They are really amazing. Nowhere else you can expect such combinations. Mandi in first house gives a beautiful personality or handsome person he may be. They can have charismatic personality in some cases. They can have leading abilities, leaders. They will be clever. In general, they will have above the level of IQ capacity. C, the most important thing, their marriage or married life will be somewhat problematic. So, Mandi in ascendant is good in general, but simultaneously, it throws some peculiar energy to 7th house, which is house of marriage and spouse. I am not taking other significations of 7th house or the 1st house. Simply three. I have posted all those things in the group. This is the group, Shankar Hegde Astrology, Shankar Hegde's Astrology class. And see, here I have given the parameters. Of course, I am not going to teach the method of calculating Mandi or Gulik, because you can refer any classics to get it. And if you use internet, easily you will get. Otherwise, my friend Roberto Velikas will try to teach you. Okay, see, these are the parameters I have given. A, handsome slash beautiful or will have charismatic and leading personalities. B, they will have good logical brain. they can be clever, or they will have above the average level of IQ simply. See, sadly, marriage or married life will be problematic. At the least, we can expect low marriage. Low marriage means somewhat against the tradition, simply we can say. Okay. Some people will have all the above set combinations and some will have only partial. I have one exceptional case also. There are no rules in predictive astrology which work up to 95% also, correct about 100%. So if a rule works up to 75% or up to 85% also, that becomes a good observation in astrology. I don't want to call it as research, I want to tell it as good observation. Here is the first set, and later on I will upload more cases, upload videos also. In fact, today itself I am going to show 25 cases. What I did, simply I used Parashara light, like this I do, go, open, sorry, file, open, see, I have plenty of charts, plenty, thousands of charts. Okay, then I simply click on charts and try to check the combinations like this, one after one. Okay, for the time being, let us forget about that and let's go to the group to check. See, the first case is of Mr. Patel. His lagna is Leo, and the Mandi or Gulik is in the lagna itself. Leo lagna and the Mandi is in first house. He is handsome, he is well educated. This youngster is worth around 400 crores. He is clever also, like any standard Gujarati business person. But unfortunately, his first marriage ended in divorce in USA. He married to another lady, but the second wife was having mental problem. So that also ended in divorce. Now he is having the third wife. Next. So all the parameters are matching in this case. Case number two. Lady astrologer of BB. She has Libra ascendant, Tula Lagna. Mandi is in the ascendant itself. In her case, she is really beautiful. She is clever also. And hers is love marriage, intercaste love marriage. So all the parameters are matching. Third, the famous case of our ex-Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Here the ascendant is Scorpio, Vrishik Lagna, and the Mandi is in the ascendant itself. As you all know, he is extremely handsome. Of course, there are other factors also. Venus and Moon are in the ascendant. He is extremely handsome, a great scholar. His IQ level was like anything. No, he is not well. That's a different thing. But his IQ level was like anything. Fantastic. But what about the 7th house? The kick related to 7th house. The peculiar negative energy related to 7th house. So he could not marry anybody. But he said, "Mai avivahit hu, lekin brahmachari nahi hu." Okay, that I don't know. But he said like that, let us forget that. Anyway, all the parameters are matching. Next case of Sri Amitabh Bachchan. Bachchan Sahib ji is having Mandi in his Kumbh Lagna, and Mandi is the charismatic personality, extremely handsome person, really clever. But his is intercaste love marriage. Again, all the parameters are matching. Forget about the rumors, like he had affairs with some other sinister, etc. I don't know, none can prove that. But anyway, all the three parameters are matching. Next, Aishwarya Rai ji, Her lagna is Kanya, Virgo lagna, and Mandi is there. Extremely beautiful, charismatic personality. What about the seventh house? She is clever also. What about the seventh house? Again, intercaste love marriage. And I don't know about the rumors related to Khans and Oberoi, etc., etc. Leave it. Next, Mr. A. Chopra. Dhanu Lagna, Sagittarius Ascendant, and Mandi is there. Like any handsome Punjabi, he is really fit, extremely beautiful. He is having a software company and a hotel in USA. But his marriage, first marriage, ended in divorce, and the second marriage is okay. So all the parameters are matching. Next, famous case of John F. Kennedy. Virgo ascendant, Kanya Lagna, and the Mandi is there itself. Gulik or Mandi, both are same, huh? So he was extremely handsome, charismatic personality. He was a top leader, clever, intelligent. What about the seventh house? There are rumors about his relationship with Marilyn Monroe. Next. See, this is a typical case. Some of you may think that having a second affair or a second marriage or third marriage, etc., are common in European or Western countries. Then how do you handle such cases? In two cases, I can prove it very well. This is the case of Elizabeth Taylor. Her Lagna or ascendant is Scorpio or Vrishika, and Mandi is in the ascendant. Okay. She was extremely beautiful, glamorous. She was really clever and talented. But what about the marriage? She married for 8 times. This is how it works in the cases of Western people. The next case is of departed soul Charlie Chaplin, again related to a Western person. His Lagna is Libra or Tula Lagna, and Mandi is there. He was also extremely handsome. He had extraordinary talents. What about the married life? The negative peculiar energy related to seventh house is clear here. He married for 4 times. Up to 3 marriages, he could not have happiness. And what happened after the 4th marriage is known to him or the God. Next. Here I started built-in charts of Parashara Light software. I went to the option actors and started checking all the charts present over there. First, I saw the case of Guru Datta, Kanya Lagna, Virgo ascendant, and the Mandi is there. Again, he was extremely handsome. He had extraordinary talents, so he was clever also. But what about the married life? Initially, I saw about him on net, and I was a bit worried because it was showing only one spouse, one wife for him, and he lived for a very short period. Then I went through Wikipedia. Initially, I thought the first case I met, which is not working totally, but afterwards Wikipedia said that he had love affair with his wife and she was a Bengali. After the rift of 3 years with family members, he finally got married to that lady. So again, all the parameters are working: handsome, clever, and love marriage. Next, Rakhi ji. Mesha ascendant, Aries ascendant, Mesha Lagna, Mandi is there. Okay, again, as you all know, She was also extremely beautiful. She was clever. She had extraordinary talents. But what about the seventh house? She married to one person and the first marriage ended in divorce. Then she married Guljarji. Next. So all the parameters are matching. Dimple Kapadiyaj. Meena Lagna or Pisces ascendant and the Mandi is in the first house. As you all know, she is also extremely beautiful. At that age, she was extraordinary. In her debut movie, Bobby, she attracted people like anything, which is known to all. So, extremely beautiful is matching. Clever is matching. Then, what about the married life? She married to Rajesh Khannaji and the marriage ended in divorce. And after the divorce, she revealed that she was not at all happy with Rajesh Khannaji. Next, all the parameters matched. Shashi Kapoorji. Capricorn or Makara Lagna, Capricorn ascendant, Mandi is there. Again, a charismatic personality, handsome, had extraordinary talents. But what about the married life? He married to a foreign lady, mostly a British lady. Okay. So, all the parameters are matching. Maybe he was romantic, who knows. Next. Kishore Kumar. See the beauty of this chart. Ascendant Dhanu is having both Saturn and Mandi. Both are dark. He was extremely beautiful. For Dhanu Lagna, both Saturn and Mandi are in the ascendant. And he was extremely handsome. He had extraordinary talents. He was clever. But what about the married life? He could not have happiness till three marriages and he had to go for the fourth marriage. Again, all the parameters are matching. Next, Hemamalini. Once upon a time, she was known as the dream girl, dream lady. Cancer ascendant, Mandi is there. Karkalakam and Mandi is there. So, still, she is extremely beautiful. That's matching. Extraordinary talent she had, clever. And what about the married life? Love marriage took place, obviously, with Dharmendra ji. But at that time itself, Dharmendra ji was married and had two children. Next. Here I stopped checking the charts of film stars and I decided to go for common people, which I will show one by one. Now the cases are from my data bank and most of them are well known to all. This is the case of an extremely rich and handsome politician, a sitting MLA, one of the most eligible backers of the entire world probably. Mithuna Lagna, Gemini ascendant and the Mandi is there, obviously. He is extremely handsome, well-educated, extremely rich, extremely clever, but still not married. And he is not willing to marry at all. So again, all the parameters are matching. Next. Handsome politician, two marriages. This person is present in Facebook and is my close friend also. See, again the Meena Lagna, Pisces ascendant, Mandi is there. Pretty handsome and really intelligent also, clever businessman. He has commanding abilities because he held some standard posts in his political party. But first marriage ended in divorce and now he is happy with the second marriage. But first marriage ended in divorce. So all the parameters are matching. Next. Jay Chopra. Actually, she is the wife of A. Chopra ji, which I showed in the first set. Her ascendant is Libra, Tula Lagna and Mandi is there. She is not much beautiful, just okay type lady. But she is extremely clever. She is a real partner of her husband in business also. Again, her first marriage ended in divorce and she is the second wife of A. Chopra ji. So two parameters are matching, clever, and seventh house related things are matching, but she is not extremely beautiful. That's okay. Next case. My wife's friend. Aries ascendant. Mandi is there in the Mesha Lagna, and Mandi is there. She is not extremely beautiful, just normal look, but extremely intelligent, a rank student. So clever also. Unfortunately, she lost her husband very early in her life. And remember this combination, Mars with Mandi, later on I will try to decode it. Because in her case, related to childbirth, there are some secrets. Next. My cousin. This is the case of my cousin. Her Lagna is again Meena. Mandi is there. Okay. Mandi or Gulik is in the ascendant. Okay. Pretty fair. Just above the average type of look. She is clever. And hers is intercaste love marriage. So almost all parameters are matching. This is the chart of TV star. Actually, her husband is more famous. He does roles in some serials and movies. Gemini ascendant. Mandi or Gulika is in the ascendant itself. She is having just moderate look. Fair color, but just moderate look, not having strong personality. But she is clever. What about the seventh house? She lived with her husband, living together concept, a very new concept for India. And later on, some unhappy developments took place. Finally, love marriage has taken place, but the marriage is still shaky. This is the case of well-known figure Sanjay Pathakji. While opening the charts randomly, suddenly I saw this chart. Again, Karka Lagna, Mars and Mandi are together, Cancer ascendant, and Mars and Mandi are together. Extremely handsome person, having commanding abilities, and he is highly influential also. When he was the head of Aatak, he used to call ministers like anything. Then I asked him, Pataki, whether yours is love marriage or what? He said, yes, mine is love marriage. So, all the parameters are matching. Next, Mahatma Gandhi ji. Libra Lagna, Tula Lagna, and the Mandi is there itself. I think he had just ordinary looks, but he had commanding nature. He was extremely intelligent. But what about the seventh house? I am not clear. According to his biography, he did some experiments. That is the famous book, My Experience, My Experiments with Truth. But he has not inferred anything. He did experiments. What was the inference? We don't know. So in this case, I think some things are matching and some things are not known to anybody. Here is the last case. My close relative. This is the Scorpio ascendant and the Mars is in the seventh. Okay, Mandi is in the ascendant. She is having normal look. No problem related to marriage. She is clever. So only one thing is matching. But the negative things related to seventh house is not present in this case. So I can consider it as the exceptional case. But check the thing here. Mandi in the ascendant in the Scorpio and aspected by Mars. If we take the case of Sanjay Pathakji, again, Mandi is in the ascendant with the Mars. I told about another case also. See, in my wife's friend's chart, again, Mandi and Mars are together in the ascendant. Hers was the case of adoption. Pathakji's case and my close relative's case are similar. It is delayed childbirth. So, there are other factors related to Mandi plus Mars. I will decode all those things later on. I will try to decode. Okay, so for the time being, you can check all these things by joining my group, Shankar Hegde's Astrology Class. So till that, thank you, namaste, and bye.